I'm Sebastian Davies, a learning experience expert at Dassault Systèmes, and welcome to this video on optimizing attributes in DraftSight. In this video, I will show you how to improve your design process by setting attribute behaviors to obtain a preferred result during or after creation. I will also describe how to order attributes in a block to reduce addition times, and look at how to employ fields to populate attribute values automatically. So, let's get started. Currently, we have a schematic open, but no border. So we will add one using the insert block command. The block has multiple attributes applied, and due to the attribute's behavior settings, we are prompted to fill in the information in the command line. During the insertion, there are a few issues with the block attributes that we need to resolve. The first issue to address is that we were prompted to apply values to the columns. For this border, we always use numeric values, so we can specify that the values are fixed. This can be done while creating attributes, but as these are already in place, we will select them and then modify the fixed value using the properties. There is also no revision number. To add one, we'll use define block attribute command. Here, we can apply a name and caption and set the behavior to predefined. With this done, we'll close the block. It's always prudent to check changes, so we will delete the border and insert it again. Neither the fixed columns nor the new predefined revision attribute shows prompts during the insertion, making it easier for future users to work with. A simple way to populate attribute information into the border after insertion is by double-clicking on it to access the Advanced Attribute Edit dialog. This lists all of the attributes in the block except the columns. This is because we defined their behavior as being fixed. Scrolling to the end, we can see the last attribute added, the revision number. By setting this attribute's behavior as predefined, we are not prompted to populate it during insertion, but can modify it later when a revision has been made. Attributes can be reordered in the block using the Block Attribute Manager or Batman command. This provides a one-stop shop that lets us reorder attributes, change their text settings, and even the individual attributes' display and behavior. Defining a precise attribute order in our blocks makes it easier for the designers to locate and populate the attribute information. We have been informed of a part change to an existing symbol, so we will edit the manufacturer and part number attributes to update it. With this done, we will apply revisions to the border. We will do this using the Advanced Attribute Edit command. We will apply a revision letter, then select the revision date field. Rather than enter a date manually, we will insert a field. We use fields in conjunction with attributes to create variable values. We want a date associated to this revision, so we will select a preferred format from those available and click OK. Although it is faster to create and place a field than an attribute, there are benefits to including the field variable in an attribute. The first is context while editing the attributes, but that's not all. By using the field string in an attribute, we can extract it to an external file that can then be leveraged to populate tables into our drawings.